Another bombshell in Canberra. Our political editor, Peter Van Onselen, has exclusive details tonight on how Scott Morrison has been poleaxed by his own cabinet, which now seems to have lost confidence in his judgement. And how the Prime Minister himself declared he was putting his leadership on the line, but still got rolled. This is hugely damaging after an already damaging 2 weeks of name-calling, backstabbing and witch hunts within the government. PVO joins me now live. Peter, one way or another, is this enough to spell the end of Scott Morrison?
I wouldn't necessarily go that far, Sandra, but I tell you what, it is incredibly damaging. I mean, we had his character before this being called into question by his own colleagues, calling him a liar, a fraud, a hypocrite, a horrible, horrible person, even a complete psycho. Now we know that the cabinet are questioning his political judgment, and that's the one big thing that he was regarded to really have a strong set of cards when it comes to. Take a look.
After a week from hell, things are only getting worse for Scott Morrison. On Monday, his own cabinet turned on him. One senior minister telling me things erupted, all over a sneaky deal the PM hatched, trying to get his religious freedom bill through the parliament. In exchange, he'd allowed debate on his now dead promise to set up a federal corruption watchdog, knowing full well it would go nowhere.
The Prime Minister tried to wedge Labor and ended up wedging himself.
This is a bill that I earnestly hoped would unite.
But we now know it's dividing his inner sanctum. Sydney MP Trent Zimmerman, for one, just can't stomach the religious freedom bill.
It's an opportunity that I can't let go past. I could not live with myself if I didn't seek to address those issues.
He crossed the floor, and so did four other Liberals, voting with the crossbench and Labor on an amendment to protect transgender children. That sent the bill to the Senate, but instead of a showdown, it's all on ice, pending an inquiry.
The Prime Minister began Monday's cabinet meeting by declaring he was putting his leadership on the line. This is hugely important because he got rolled, even when he had so much at stake. His own cabinet colleagues didn't trust his political judgment.
Close Morrison confidant Stuart Robert argued for the PM in cabinet, but remained tight-lipped today.
Well, I guess I didn't see you in cabinet, PVO, and I did have a good look around the room.
I've clearly spoken to someone there, though. What does it mean that the Prime Minister got rolled in cabinet on that, if you like, political strategy?
Well, clearly I don't agree with you, and I was there, and you weren't.
Are you saying that didn't happen in cabinet?
I'm saying I don't discuss matters of cabinet confidentiality.
Communications Minister Paul Fletcher was one of those who argued forcefully against the Prime Minister. Another minister said in the meeting the Prime Minister's horse trading would cause more problems than it solves. One Liberal telling 10 News First, Scott Morrison was being too tricky by half. In the end, Cabinet rolled its Prime Minister, prompting one minister to say the PM looks rattled. Not surprising, given he'd put his leadership on the line, and not even his own Cabinet backed his political judgment.
One of the big reasons that the Cabinet was concerned about bringing the Integrity Commission information forward as legislation was because they didn't want retrospective laws to be put in place. In other words, that's a concern about their past conduct as a government being investigated by just such a body in the future. Now, we reached out to the Prime Minister's office. They gave us the same line that you heard there from Stuart Robert. They don't comment on Cabinet discussions.
It's not over yet. All right, Peter, thank you.